Hello everybody, today I have the review of the Xbox 360 Kinect. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get straight on into this. Going to show some clips of what it looks like to actually be viewing somebody playing this, because it actually looks kind of funny, and you'll get to see me dance a little bit on Dance Central. Xbox. Play disc.
Yo, check it. Gonna wanna memorize my moves. I bust moves like a mint makes money.
When the pimp's in the crib, ma, drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. When the pigs try to get at you, park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. If a get an attitude, pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. I got the rodeo on and I'm pouring Sean Don and I'm all the best. Cause I got it going on. I'm a nice dude. Some ice cream, see these ice cubes, see these ice creams, LGBT bachelor, $1 million bow, that's whiter than what's spilling down your...
Bust.
Get shot down cause you're overzealous, play hard to get, you males get jealous. Okay, smarty, go to a party. Girls are scantily clad and showing body. A chick walks by, you wish she could sex you, but you're standing on the wall like you was Poindex. Girls start walking, guys start gawking. Sits down next to you and starts talking. Says she wanna dance cause she likes the groove. So come on, fat so and just bust the move. Someone could cure your lonely condition. Looking for love in all the wrong places. No fire, but every dark tunnel has a light of hope. So don't hang yourself with a celibate though. Your movie's showing, so you're going. Put your nice stuff on the vibe you're blowing. Get it.
You got it. You want it, baby.
Just watch the movie.
So as far as the design aspect of this thing goes, it's an all-black design with a chrome rod that goes down to the base, which tilts to adjust the sensors so that it will detect your whole body. And it is a total fingerprint magnet. It is absolutely terrible on fingerprints, but again, you probably aren't going to be touching it too much because you're basically just going to set it down on whatever you're going to and it'll automatically tilt to sense your whole body. Now, as far as the specs go on this device, it's got color and depth sensing lenses, so it can detect what color your shirt is and things like that, and it can determine how far away from the sensor you actually are. It's got a multi-microphone array for chat and voice commands, so if you want to use it for Xbox Live chat, you can go ahead and use that. It'll have you set it up so that it won't detect the TV in the background, but it's not too good at it, I'm not gonna lie. It also has a tilt motor for sensor adjustment, like I said, in the design aspect. It's got a horizontal view of 57 degrees outwards. It's got a vertical of 43 degrees up and down. And it can tilt 27 degrees up or down, depending on where you set it. maybe it's on top of your TV or maybe it's below, just like mine. It can read a depth of up to 3.5 meters, which is actually quite a ways, but like I said, at that point it's not even really worth using. Nobody's going to be standing 3.5 meters away from this device. It can stream up to 640p 32-bit color at 30 frames per second, and it has 16-bit audio, which is actually pretty good for the first generation of this device. It can track up to 6 people at once with 20 joints each, so that means it'll track your knees, feet, ankle, all that stuff if you can get all that in there with 6 people in the sensor area. But you can only play with 2 people on any game. I don't know why they would be able to track up to 6 people, but maybe it's so that when somebody walks by, it doesn't sense them too well, but we'll never know. And it also wants you, in most games, to stand 6 to 10 feet away. Even though it can sense up to 3.5 meters, it's not really going to be useful at that point, so 6 to 10 feet away is a very good distance from the sensor. If you can't get that distance, that just means you won't be able to fit 2 people in at one point. Another cool thing about this device is it can recognize facial features. So that what that means is I can walk in front of the sensor like I'll show you, and it'll automatically recognize that it's me, which is actually pretty good for first generation. And it can also recognize multiple languages, so let's say you're in Belgium and you're speaking Belgian, it'll automatically know, hey, he's speaking Belgian, so he says, you know, play disc or whatever. But like I said, it's pretty good for first generation, but we'll see what they can make improvements on. Now, as far as features go on this, the actual cord that is on the back is a little different than a USB cord, which is why you have to have either a new Xbox, I'm not exactly sure what they call it, I think it's the Xbox 360 Slim, or you have to have a adapter which will plug into the USB port on your original Xbox, and then it will also plug into the back USB port and certain things like that. I'm not exactly sure because I got the new Xbox along with the Kinect, but if you have one of those, the adapter comes with it. The Kinect also has multiple attachments that you can put onto it. So a couple that I've seen, you can get a TV mount where it'll put it on top of the TV. And there's a couple other ones. I'll show a couple pictures over there. But yeah, it's pretty nice because if you're too close to the sensor while it's down below the TV, if you get it above, it might be a little bit more further away because it also has to sense downwards. So if you have troubles getting 6 to 10 feet away, then go ahead and grab an attachment that'll connect to your TV because that'll work pretty well. Another great thing about this device is it also has a very long cord to go along with it. The cord cannot come out of the Kinect itself, but it can come out of the 360, of course. But I'm guessing this is just to fit any room that it needs to be. Maybe you had the Xbox on the far right or something and you want the Kinect on the left. I'm not exactly sure, but it comes with a very long cord, like I said. Another couple of great things about this device is it's very, very, very easy to set up once you first get it. They go ahead and ask you, hey, do you want to Kinect? And then you go ahead and click yes with your controller, and then it'll tell you to set down your controller. And basically from there, it's just setting up the microphone so that it won't sense the TV, setting up the sensors so that it knows that you're 6 to 10 feet away, and other things like that. It's very, very easy. It guides you through the whole process with ease. In some games, it also has auto player sensing, which is really cool because they say you can jump into Kinect, and literally you can jump into Kinect. You can just jump into frame, it'll sense you on some games only. One of them is Kinect Adventures. You can go ahead and jump right in and it'll sense you and put 2 players on the screen. And a lot of games include pictures, which it has a camera on the front that'll take full color pictures. It's not that great a camera, but it works. And some of the pictures are actually pretty funny, I'm not gonna lie. The absolute biggest thing about this device that I can't stand, I don't know why they can't fix this, hopefully they'll do it in the second generation, but it's that it degrades in daylight hours. Now, what that means is once it starts getting daylight out, the sensor will eventually start degrading and you won't be able to swipe across the screen or select things with your hand. It gets really, really hard. And trust me, I know what I'm talking about. I have plenty of windows through the house here, and it gets really, really annoying if you want to play during the day. So it's great for like night parties and things like that. If you're a morning person like I am, playing in the morning's fun too. But during the day, it's basically useless because the sensor can't sense you. I'm guessing that's because of the IR sensor on the front, and that the sunlight will affect the rays that go through space. So hopefully they'll fix it in the second generation, but we'll have to see. On the front of this device, you also have a full color camera, a motion sensing camera, a status light, and you also have an IR light on the front as well. Disclaimer for anyone trying to play the Kinect. The Kinect has an IR sensor on the front, as I've mentioned, and IR blasts are very, very bad for your eyes. Trust me, if you look into the sensor for a long, long time, you will damage your eyes. So please, please don't directly look at the IR sensor because your eyes will, you might go blind, is what I'm basically saying. As for my actual review of this device, it is a world-changing device at this point. It is the first device to ever be able to track somebody with no controller at all. Wii and Sony Move, or whatever they call it, doesn't work. Not just one person, but two people. It can track two people at once. Actually, up to six people. It measures depth. It measures, you know, color, everything. And it also takes pictures. And you can also video chat all on this one little device. It's extremely amazing. It looks great. Not very much that needs to be upgraded to your normal Xbox. Or if you want to get a new Xbox, you don't even have to upgrade anything. It works straight out of the box. So, like I said, it's a world-changing device. Nothing compares to it at all yet. And I hope to see what happens in the new generation. So thanks guys for watching. I'm going to have to remind you to click subscribe at the top there. And click the like button down there. It only takes a few seconds. And go ahead and leave a comment on what you think of this review. I work really hard on these. And I think I should get more views and things like that. So go ahead and tell your friends, favorite it if you want to. And thanks for watching guys. Peace.